The Quad A City Championship game about to unfold. A crisp, cold day, not as cold as it's been. Breezy, to wind blowing at 11 miles an hour or more. We had a chance to talk to both coaches before the game about their philosophy heading in, and it begins with the Benjamin Franklin's coach, David Carter, who described himself as a man of few words.
You know, hopefully today our offense come and do what we ask them to do, and the defense play their style of football and let the bricks fall how they fall.
I think our game plan starts with defense. We're going to have to find a way to slow down a very explosive Ben Franklin offense. Really high-powered, run by their quarterback, number 12, and it all starts and begins there with our defensive game plan.
So, Kevin, a lot of excitement here. We are covering two games today. Coming up later on this afternoon, the AAA championship game. That'll be Imhotep against Archbishop Wood. But right now, Gabe Infante, coach of St. Joe's Prep, taking his team against Benjamin Franklin and their coach David Carter for the Quad A City Championship game.
And there's Coach Carter today. He's worried about that prolific run offense that the Prep has, the 1-2 punch in Zacchaeus and Swift. And on the other side, we've talked to Infante. He's worried about the passing attack led by Kevin Caldwell. So we have a very good offense running the football and another good one passing the ball. Let's see which one comes out on top today, John.
There's the sophomore DeAndre Swift, and to his left will be the senior Olamide Zacchaeus, as Benjamin Franklin will be kicking it off to start the football game, and St. Joseph's Prep will be receiving. Franklin winning its first public league title since 1966. St. Joe's Prep, meantime, a regular winner of, or at least competitor for, Catholic League championships, and now the two teams go head-to-head. It'll be Franklin kicking it off, and it is fielded by Swift, who is bumped at the 20 and brought down there. So a good job by the Franklin coverage team, and St. Joseph's Prep will start first and 10 right at about its own 20-yard line. A player shaken up.
There was a tackler on the play. Yeah. He made a great play. It's number 44. Get his
Brian Harvey.
Yeah, take a look at Brian Harvey here. Breaks through, hits Swift high, and then brings him down at the ankles. Great play by the special teamer. Hard to tackle any one of these two guys, Swift or Zacchaeus, one-on-one. It was just done there. I think he might have rolled his ankle there, John. Mm. Taking a look at it.
So Brian Harvey at 5'7", 180, a junior. All public league selection. Primarily plays on the defensive side.
But he did make a great play. I'm not sure I'd be kicking off to those two guys, John. I think Swift and Zacchaeus being back there, that would scare me. But they're going to be starting. St. Joe's Preps will be starting at the 20-yard line. So really good job by the kickoff team from Franklin.
And their quarterback is Jack Clements, 6'4", 210-pound senior. Has completed 100 of 168 passes. That's over 59%. He's thrown for more than 1,500 yards, and he's got 19 touchdowns. So St. Joe's Prep on offense to start it. And this is Zacchaeus on first down. He's got another first down, breaking down the left sideline. Zacchaeus almost to the 50-yard line.
And here's what we were talking about. This offense is incredible. This is just a dive up the middle. But watch how Zacchaeus, after he gets through the hole, makes a great move and gets to the outside. And you can see the power that he's got there and also the speed. Great pickup. You see him go, there was nothing really open on the inside, and he took it right to the outside with that speed. A big pickup for the Prep.
26-yard gain and a first down at their own 46-yard line. Clements now hands it off to Swift. Bump behind the line, gets away from one man, crosses midfield across the 45, and another first down, almost to the 40-yard line. Let's take a look at the Ben Franklin defense. And it begins with Taj Clea, one of their top players, 6'4", senior. Demir Jones, Kevin McLeod-Holman, and Jameer Williams rounding out the line. Linebackers Edward Dennis, Nyfese Ewell, and Brian Harvey. Harvey, the player who's just injured earlier. And then in the defensive secondary, it'll be Jaquan Carlisle, Corion Carlisle, Davin Thompson, and Keom Edgefield. First and 10 at the 40-yard line. Now they put the ball in the hands
That was John Reed.
Of John Reed, yeah.
And that was a speed sweep right there. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you can't fall asleep with John Reed while you're watching Zacchaeus and Swift because he's very capable back also. He picks up a quick 6 yards there.
Quick look at the names of the players in the secondary. Jaquan and Corian Carlisle are twins. And then Davin Thompson and Keon Edgefield rounding out the defensive backfield. Gain of about 5. It'll be second down and 5 at the 34-yard line. And here's Swift through a big opening. Cuts to his left. Back up the middle. Across the 20 to the 19-yard line.
Well, we're really seeing some of this running that we expected. Here is another quick hitting. Dive up the middle. These guys don't hesitate to take it to the open area, and that was the outside. And you see Swift right there with the power and the speed to pick up another first down for the prep.
They mark the ball at the 20-yard line. We have a timeout now as David Carter, the Ben Franklin coach, stops the clock to huddle his team up and see if they could reset. It'll be first and 10 for St. Joe's Prep at the 20-yard line. Hey, before Chip Kelly leads the Eagles against the Tennessee Titans, break down the Birds' game plan on Eagles pregame live from Xfinity Live. And then after the game, Eagles postgame live as Coach Kelly's press conference plus expert analysis with total coverage starting Sunday, tomorrow at noon, only on Comcast Sportsnet. All right, so right out of the box, the St. Joe's Prep running attack, which we spoke about before the game, is looking very effective.
There's John Runyon's son, John Daniel Runyon, headed to Michigan. Gosh, John, I can remember when he was a toddler and I was watching the Eagles and going to some of their practices.
Yeah, he's no toddler. 6'6", 285 pounds. He's come a long way. Play back in. First and 10 at about the 19-yard line. Clemens throws complete. John Reed catching it and then spun out of bounds. John Reed at 5'10", 190, a senior, 33 catches this year for more than 600 yards.
You see Franklin's defense playing a little off the ball. The prep takes advantage of that. Reed just goes down and does a quick comeback, wide open, and a pickup of about 6 yards.
They'll spot the ball at about the 14-yard line, call it second down and 5. Handoff to Swift. This is a loose football. Comes right back to him. He leans to the goal line, and he's in. Touchdown, St. Joseph's Prep. Maybe not the way they diagrammed it, but that's 6 points anyway.
That's the way the ball bounces. He fumbled this, and it came back to him. Watch this. And you can see he's just trying to give it that second effort. He was tied up at the ankle. Gets through the line. Heads to the outside again. Right there, the ball is stripped. He keeps his eye on it. I would have fallen on it, but he picks it up, bounces right up to him. Look, reaches out and gets it into the end zone for a touchdown.
Nick Bill is the place kicker on to add the extra point. We have whistles blowing as he steps up to the football. In any case, an 80-yard drive by St. Joseph's Prep. 6 plays.
Penalize half the distance to the goal. Replay the try.
Yeah, take a look at this. They don't have instant replay and challenges, but I think he's down before that ball reaches. You can see his knee's down. Yeah, that should have been down at the 1 yard line.
But with without the benefit of appeals and instant replays as part of the official,
very subjective.
it does stand as a touchdown. The extra point going through, and it is 7-0.
And this is a common theme so far in this first drive. They head up inside, but they quickly try to get outside. This time the ball stripped. Swift picks it back up, and I think he was down at the 1, looking at it from that angle also. Great blocking, though, up front. And we talked about this offensive line. 4 starters back from last year's state championship team, and it certainly showed on that drive, John.
So it is 7-0. St. Joseph's Prep out to the early lead. But Benjamin Franklin will be having its opportunity in just a moment. 80-yard drive, very impressive. March down the field.
Very efficient drive. 6 plays, 80 yards. Only took up about a minute and 35 seconds.
Gabe Infante in his 5th year as coach at St. Joseph's Prep from North Jersey.
He coached at Paramus. He was the head coach for 2 years up there.
Mm-hmm. Started his career as a corporate attorney. And said, you know what, this is just not for me. And
followed his passion.
Followed his passion, rolled the dice a little bit, and he's become a very successful high school football coach. All right, Nick Bill will be kicking it off. And back deep is Rasheem James, number 11.
Maybe Coach Infante can use that expertise to help John Daniel Runyon when he's entering the NFL. Maybe be his agent, you know, could come in handy.
With the wind, the ball not staying up on the tee, so it'll be held. A short kickoff coming up, and a loose football. James falls on it. Did they blow the whistle?
We're going to see if they blew the whistle, but that ball was bouncing all around. Let's just see the end of this, because this ball was, like it had grease on it. Looks like they've got it there. They continue to fumble it. They couldn't even fall on it correctly. And then it comes in. Let's see who ends up with it.
Number 20, Nyfese Yule.
They're going to say Yule recovered that for Ben Franklin, so they'll be starting at their 21-yard line.
Kevin Caldwell, the quarterback we talked about before the game, 5'9", 190-pound senior, had a great season in the process of having a great season. 35 touchdown passes so far this year, a city record, public or Catholic League. A city record 35 touchdown passes. Whips it out on the left side, and that ball is dropped on first down. So Franklin having a little bit of trouble getting going. Rafael Rodriguez, the intended receiver there. Looking at the rest of the lineup, Jaimeer Tony, a player headed to Marshall University next year. And then the slot back, Michael Kane. Rafael Rodriguez, the leading receiver, but also good ones in Rasheem James and Javier Buffalo. Offensive line, Taj Clea, Julian Montgomery, Deion Jones, Steve Ashley Barkley, and Troy Conyers. Drop pass, so it'll be second down and 10 at the 21-yard line. Caldwell, the senior quarterback. Whips it short, complete. And it'll be a gain of about 4 yards. Take a look at the St. Joseph's Prep defense. Four-man line, Joe Dumond, Armin Ware, Alec Dirks, and Jake Strain, one of the leaders on defense. The linebackers, Thomas Johnson, Nick Vanderveer in the middle, and then Sean Harris. And in the defensive secondary, John Reed, Benny Walls, Dylan Delius, and Justin Montague. Gain of about 4 on the pass completion. It'll now be 3rd and 6. Rush coming. Caldwell gets away, fires, complete. Javier Buffalo, does he have enough for the first down?
It's going to be really close, John.
It'll be close.
He had it until he tried to make a move, but I think they're going to give it to him. They're going to say it's a first down. And watch, this is why Kevin Caldwell's so good. He's flushed out of the pocket, throws the ball on the run, just a wrist action. Great throw, very, very accurate, and just a wrist throw. That's why he's got a 66% completion average.
First and 10 at the 32-yard line. They hand it off to Tony. Jaimeer Tony trying to find some room and inches forward to about the 35.
3-yard pickup by Tony there. A little speed sweep. Trying to keep the prep defense honest.
Nick Vanderveer, the middle linebacker, number 4, making the tackle.
And he's a good one. Keep your eye on him. One of the leaders on their defense.
3-yard gain. It'll be second down and 7. St. Joe's Prep leading in the early going, 7-0. St. Joe's Prep, the Quad A Catholic League champion this year. Pass complete to Javier Buffalo across the 40, out to about the 41-42, close to another first down.
Buffalo on second effort there, picks up an additional 2 yards. St. Joe's has got 7 guys into the passing defense, only a 4-man rush. So Franklin has taken advantage of these short passes that are there, and they're picking up yardage.
That is enough for a first down, a 7-yard gain, just enough for a first down. So Franklin able to move the sticks again. First and 10 at their own 42. Caldwell setting up in the shotgun here. Behind center, Deion Jones. Quick pass right flat. He overthrew this one. Incomplete, intended for Edward Dennis.
You don't see that often, but that time Caldwell overthrew his man. And the key on that is throwing the ball to that receiver while he's moving forward.
David Carter, head coach of the Benjamin Franklin High School team, says his team succeeds because they play with a chip on their shoulder. And they've succeeded mightily this year. Ben Franklin, the Public League Quad A champion this year with a 10-0 record, a sack here as Caldwell was brought down by Vandeveer in the backfield, and Jake Strain, number 10, was
there
as well.
And you see the prep, St. Joe's prep put a blitz on this time, and it was not blocked well by Franklin, and they get Kevin Caldwell down, and unblocked. You see there an unblocked Vandeveer comes off the edge and trips up Caldwell, who was flushed out of the pocket.
So now it's third down in about a mile. Third down in about 20. Call it 21. They have to get to the opposing 48-yard line. So third down at 21. And let's see if Caldwell can come up with something here. Trips right, one man split left. Tony in the backfield next to Caldwell. No blitz. Long pass downfield, man open, complete, first down, ho-ho! Rasheem James finding a seam in the zone, and Caldwell put it on his hands.
It's interesting, St. Joe's has been giving the underneath pass all day, and this is what they don't want to give up, this long pass. But a seam pass, like you said, James ran the seam, went up to the outside, and I'll tell you what, Caldwell let this ball go before James had even made that outside move. Great timing pattern by the young quarterback.
26-yard gain on a third and 21, and the Electrons are in business at the prep 43-yard line. Caldwell going to hand it off this time. Edward Dennis carrying the football, a couple of yards.
You know, John, Caldwell really looks to me, and we're going to talk to him at halftime.
Tony with the carry.
Tony with the carry, but Caldwell is showing a lot of poise out there. You know, St. Joe's comes right down and scores on six plays, and he's like, okay, now we're going to do our thing. And he's very poised out there at quarterback. I'm very impressed with his ability to not get rattled under pressure here.
Second down at 7. Caldwell looks, complete again. Javier Buffalo, first down, and Franklin continues to move the sticks.
This is amazing. Caldwell threw that one like a dart. Watch his arm movement. He doesn't even bring it back far. This is thrown like a dart and really, really on target. Just a little, like, touch pass to his slant man who was coming inside. Again, Vandeveer on the tackle there.
And it's first down. Ball at the 31-yard line. Caldwell still has the football. It is bobbled and dropped, incomplete.
I like that play there. That gives Caldwell the opportunity of throwing the ball or running the football. It was a fake to his halfback. And I think his two receivers just got a little too close together there. And they brought some of the St. Joe's defensive backs with them.
Caldwell now 4 of 7 passing for 44 yards.
Two drops.
Yeah, really just made the one bad pass and everything else has been on target. Second and 10 at the 31. Set up a screen here. Well read by the prep defense. Pass completed, as you saw, to Jaimeer Tony, but stopped after a very short gain.
You watch the prep. They're keeping four guys on that defensive line, and they've got seven guys back. They're giving up the underneath pass. They're keeping everything in front of them, with the exception of the pass that James made for 26 yards.
Play really just got back to the line of scrimmage. Alec Dirks, number 44, leading the tackling charge on the screen pass. And it'll be third down and 10. Caldwell under pressure here. Fires, has a man open in the end zone. Touchdown, Rafael Rodriguez. Ho-ho! Caldwell able to scramble away from the rush and find senior receiver Rafael Rodriguez in the end zone. And Ben Franklin draws close again.
And now you see why this kid's thrown for 35 touchdown passes.
36?
36 now, but 35 up to this point. Watch this. He gets some pressure on himself here. He never panics, pushes himself up in the pocket, and then again off his back foot with one, you know, quick arm movement. He throws the touchdown right on target.
Now the extra point try. And it is no good. And so it is still a one-point game, but Benjamin Franklin has made it close. St. Joe's Prep 7, Franklin 6.
All right, 215, show us what you got. I'm talking to you, North Philly, South Philly.
Welcome back to Northeast High School in Northeast Philadelphia off of Cottman Avenue. The Quad A Philadelphia City Championship game, Hawk 7, Electron 6. Both teams with scoring drives to get the game going. St. Joe's Prep started it out with an impressive drive, mostly on the ground.
Six plays, 80 yards. It was Swift and Zacchaeus, the 1-2 punch. Here's Swift. These guys will take it outside in a heartbeat after they go up the middle. And here's a touchdown play. You won't see one like this in a long time. A fumble, a recovery, and maybe a touchdown, but it counts.
It counts.
So, John, we've seen both offenses play as advertised.
Yeah, marching down the field and scoring the football. And Gabe Infante's team will be getting it back here. You have to be impressed with Benjamin Franklin, right? The St. Joe's Prep team comes out of the gate, marches down the field, an opportunity to be demoralized if you're the opposition, but we didn't see that at all.
Not at all. And, you know, really, really impressed with Kevin Caldwell's poise during that drive. I'm not so sure he's got the greatest mechanics in the world, but he's got the confidence and an arm that is uncanny to be that accurate without having the mechanics.
All right, so Franklin will be kicking it off now. Number 15, Javier Buffalo, one of the receivers, is their kickoff man. DeAndre Swift, the exciting sophomore, back deep with senior Olamide Zaccheaus. It is a line drive kick beyond the reach of the receivers into and through the end zone for a touchback. And the Prep will be starting first and 10 at its own 20-yard line. City championship game. Winner of this one plays Parkland in the state quarterfinals. Parkland from the Lehigh Valley winning its game against Easton last night. And really as much at stake with just the value of the city championship as advancing in the state playoffs.
Without a doubt. And you've got a team in St. Joe's Preps. A lot of these kids were on that ride last year to the state championship. And that experience can really come in handy in this playoff run.
6'4 senior quarterback Jack Clements hands it off here. Olamide Zaccheaus accelerating through an opening. And another big game for the senior, Olamide Zaccheaus.
All right, so what Ben Franklin did here, they put nine guys in the box trying to stop this run. That's a good play, but you got to make the play at the line of scrimmage. A missed tackle like that, because once you get past those nine guys, there's nobody back there to really help you. And that was a great play by number 28. Bringing down Swift. Zaccheaus, I'm sorry. And there's Zaccheaus again.
Zaccheaus
right up
again.
The middle. This time not breaking to the outside, just taking the ball and taking what he could get. And you see the power he's got. Great lower body strength in both of these young runners.
Zaccheaus with just over 500 yards rushing coming into the game. 77 carries, 507 yards on the ground. A 6.6 yards per carry average. You got four here. And it'll be second down at 6. Just inside the 5-minute mark in the first quarter, it's a 1-point game. And a defensive play stopping James Bell, their third running back. A loss on the play, a good job by the Franklin defense. David Thompson, freshman safety, number 28.
Franklin had eight guys up in the box again, this time a speed sweep to Bell, and he just can't turn the corner. Great job of stringing the play out by the Franklin defense.
Loss of yardage, ball coming back to the 47-yard line. Make it third down and 7. St. Joe's Prep mostly running, and you see Franklin mostly passing when it had the ball, but this is a passing situation for the Hawks. Third and 7 at their own 47-yard line. And let's see what Jack Clements, the senior quarterback, can come up with here. He's looking. Now on the scramble. Throws beyond the reach of DeAndre Swift, and it'll be fourth down.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm really impressed with that defense coming back and getting the St. Joe's Prep offense out there that quickly, you know, after that six-play, 80-yard drive. John, you're right, it could demoralize you. But they came right back and stopped the Prep this time. And they're pumped up. Their sidelines over here is really yelling and going crazy.
Robert Caprice is on to punt for St. Joe's Prep. That's Caprice number 9, and there's Rasheem James, a junior, back deep to receive for the Electrons. Low snap. Caprice able to field it and get a decent punt away. It'll take a nice roll, a very good roll for St. Joe's Prep. And they'll wind up getting a lot out of it as the ball comes down to the 17-yard line. So Ben Franklin gets the ball again. Let's go back to what they did the first time they had the football.
Here's Kevin Caldwell scrambling, making a play underneath. That's their first down, and they continued to move the ball. And this is a play, 26-yarder, that really opened things up. But here you see Caldwell flushed up. Watch him off his back foot, just flicks the ball perfectly to Rodriguez, his favorite receiver. Touchdown number 36 on the season for Caldwell.
First and 10 at the 17-yard line. Franklin has three men wide right, one wide left. Caldwell looking deep down the right sideline beyond the reach of the intended receiver. Michael Kane, the intended target. They've got four wideouts they use, and Rafael Rodriguez has the most catches, but Caldwell has really spread the ball around between Rodriguez, Rasheem James, we saw a lot of Javier Buffalo, and now Michael Kane, the intended target.
And I asked him in our interview who was his favorite target, figuring he'd say Rodriguez, and he said, whoever's open.
There you go. You get open, I will find you. They spread out the formation again. Second down and 10 at the 17. St. Joe's Prep showing blitz. They come with the blitz. Screen right, complete. Rodriguez with the ball here. He's got first down yardage, almost up to the 30.
This is another great play by Caldwell, just so sure of himself. This is a screen play. Again, he's right on target, doesn't hesitate, gets the ball out of his hands very quickly, and they make a first down out of it. And, you know, Caldwell wants to play Division I football, and there's a lot of coaches out there say 5'9", I don't think so. But I'll tell you, somebody's got to take a look at this kid. He's very special.
Ball spotted at the 28, a first down. Hawks lead 7-6, getting into the late stages of the first quarter. They keep it on the ground here. Jaimeer Tony.
A little extracurricular activity there after the play.
Gain of about 2 on the play. Spotted at the 30.
John, I like the way they mix the run in to keep the St. Joe's Prep honest. You know, if you keep passing, they're going to wear you down with a blitz here and there, and you got to keep them honest with that running play. You watch Caldwell out there. He's making the calls. He is the manager of this team on the field.
Senior quarterback set up in the shotgun here. Facing some pressure. Dances away, now is in trouble, and down he goes. Number 34, Armin Ware at the bottom of the pile. Got there first, a sack and a big loss thrown by the St. Joe's defense.
Great play by the St. Joe's defense. Just a four-man rush, they just keep coming. Caldwell held on to the ball a little too long here, and his offensive lineman could not keep that defense from sacking their quarterback.
12-yard loss on the play. Comes back to the 20. They need to get out to their own 38-yard line, so make it 3rd and 18 as we cross the 2-minute mark in the first quarter. He had a 3rd and 21 he converted on the first drive. Let's see if he can do something like that again. He's throwing deep down the left sideline in trouble. That ball's bobbled and caught. Was it out of bounds?
We couldn't see if it was caught. I think he did catch it, but they're saying he was out of bounds when he got control.
It would have been enough for the first down, barely.
A good defensive play here. The defender arrives just the time the ball does, as you'll see. And that causes the bobble. And when he gets it under their control, now he did not catch it. He dropped it on the ground. We couldn't see it from up here, but the replay shows that he did not have control of the ball.
John Reed was the defensive player there, the future Penn State Nittany Lion. And he did have perfect timing with the contact. And so the dangerous sophomore DeAndre Swift is back deep to receive. Rafael Rodriguez is the punter for Benjamin Franklin. A little bit of a rush here. Rodriguez gets a high spiral away. And it is down by the Franklin coverage team in Franklin territory at about the 43-yard line. So St. Joe's Prep will start first and 10 at the Franklin. They'll mark at 45, the Franklin 45. Well, we've got another game coming up this afternoon, and then on to the Thanksgiving Day game. More coverage of high school football on the Comcast Network. Imhotep against Martin Luther King.
Early in the morning, 10:30. It's a great game.
Here's DeAndre Swift accelerating, racing for the goal line. Swift, touchdown, St. Joe's Prep. Right off the get-go after the punt, he blew through an opening, put on the afterburners, and streaked to the end zone. That is a 45-yard touchdown run by the sophomore DeAndre Swift.
Take a look here. We talked about this guy's a complete package. Nice hole up front for him. He breaks to the outside. Now, he's got two guys that got angles on him, but they're not going to catch him. Look at him trying to come in. What speed he's got. This kid has got the entire package. He runs well. He catches the football, and you saw the speed right there.
Extra point kick through, and now with 1:24 left in the first quarter, it is the Hawks of St. Joe's Prep 14 and the Electrons of Benjamin Franklin 6.
Here he is up the gut again, but these guys have great vision, him and Zacchaeus. And he sees that there's an opening on the outside, and he outruns everybody to the end zone. Great speed. Watch the opening that he ran through up there. But then he sees, I can get outside. He knows that the sideline is his friend. And on to the races. Mr. Swift.
Yeah, pretty good stat line for him so far. How about 3 carries, 74 yards, and 2 touchdowns?
As advertised, as I said, here they are, 24-7 average. Oh, my goodness. I don't know what Ben Franklin's going to do to stop that running attack, especially they're getting beat at the line of scrimmage by that awesome offensive line the Prep has. 4 seniors back from last year's championship team anchor that line, and they are right now really commanding a presence on the field in the trenches.
So a 45-yard touchdown run. Rasheem James back deep to receive this kickoff. It'll bounce out of bounds. That'll get flags flying. And Kevin, now again, you know, an opportunity for Benjamin Franklin to hang its head, but they absolutely did not do that after the first St. Joe's Prep touchdown, and I don't see why they would at this point either.
See what happens here. I know that they're very confident in this passing game behind Kevin Caldwell. So here's the ref.
Offense, by rule, ball will be placed on the 35-yard line. First down.
All right, and they're so going to get good field position, too, to start this drive.
Yeah, kickoff going out of bounds so that the ball comes out to the 35-yard line. And indeed, let us see what the Electrons can do. First and 10 at their own 35. They're undefeated. 10 wins and no losses. Beating up on their opponents, averaging 43 points per game. This is a team that scored at least 36 points in 9 of their 10 games. They keep it on the ground here. And they've got some room, a hard hit. But then staying on his feet and moving forward is Edward Dennis.
Edward Dennis. Wow, he took a hit when he turned it upfield and somehow kept his balance. He picks up a couple additional yards.
There's one of
Watch those. This hit here. This looked like a Barry Sanders move right here. He gets that right arm down to balance himself and keep his feet. And now it's second and a short one.
That looked like a Mikhail Baryshnikov move to me. Edward Dennis, the backup running back with 152 yards on the ground, also caught 99 yards worth of passes this season. A 9-yard gain here. And it'll be second and one at the 44. Caldwell whips it in the right flat. That's another first down. Completed pass to Rasheem James. And he's bumped out of bounds by Olamide Zacchaeus.
Well, you can see that there's a lot of familiarity between quarterback and receiver. Caldwell lets that ball go before James made his move, and it was right on target again. And I'll tell you, Caldwell throws a frozen rope for a ball. It's hard to react on it as a defensive back when it's thrown with that kind of velocity.
He's not the smoothest throw, right? It doesn't have classic mechanics. But
a lot of wrist movement in his throws, and
he delivers. He's got a first down here. In prep territory at the 48-yard line. Fumbled the ball, picked it up, completed the pass to Buffalo. And then Buffalo's got a couple of yards and is dragged down hard by Justin Montague.
Is that a, this is a double pass here. You got a pass from Caldwell to his receiver after a fumble. And they had a blitz on that time. And he throws it and catches it again.
Yeah.
You get two catches for that, John? I'm not sure.
All right, we're coming down to the end of the first quarter. And both teams' offenses operating as advertised. End of one. The Hawks of St. Joseph's Prep, 14. The Electrons of Benjamin Franklin High School, 6. The Quad A Philadelphia City Championship game continues in a moment.
Saturday, the... Get instant access to the...
There's Runyon, John Daniel Runyon, son of the former Eagle John Runyon. This John Runyon at 6'6", 285-pound senior left offensive tackle. All right, first and 10 after the pick. Jack Clements looking for a lot, fires it down the middle of the field. It is caught. Touchdown, John Reed. Ho-ho! A post pattern for Reed. Clements put it on his hands, and it's 6 for St. Joe's Prep.
Great play action by Clements to hold everybody at the line of scrimmage. And then you watch. He's watching. He throws it out there. John Reed's got a step on his man. Oh, right on target. Reed brings it in. Nice throw. Nice catch. Nice pass pattern.
Touchdown for St. Joe's Prep. Nick Bill on to add the extra point.
Now Ben Franklin's going to be called for being offsides. They'll move the extra point halfway to the goal line.
It is a 43-yard touchdown pass.
Beautiful play. John Reed, you see there, 35 receptions this year, 12 touchdowns.
And now the extra point
is blocked.
Is blocked.
Second blocked extra point we've had today. You don't expect that from two teams that are playing in the championship, but it gets done.
And so the score remains St. Joe's Prep 20, Benjamin Franklin 6.
Take another look at his touchdown. Perfect pass. Came right down the chute to John Reed. And you see Reed beat his man, just outran him and getting the spacing he needed. Watch John Daniel Runyon here doing the job that he needs to do. Yeah, that's the best electronic defender right there, too, just keeping him at bay. Taj Clea.
And, Kevin, it's the second one-play drive, if you will, quote-unquote drive, of the game. This is a 43-yard pass on the first play of the drive. Earlier we had a 45-yard run by Swift on the first play of a drive.
Here's the block extra point. Let's see what happens there. Wow! Who was that that got up that high? One of them.
Yeah.
So that's,
I think it was Clea.
Yep. You can see this guy's got some talent. He's not very, you know, bulky. And he can put on a lot of weight, but he's a really good athlete.
All right, so Nick Bill, number 33, will be kicking off. Rasheem James is back deep to receive. And we're back in action. Line drive kickoff. Here's James at the 15. Got some moves, this guy. Too much coverage defense there, and he has stopped at the 25. So about a 10-yard return by junior Rasheem James. And Benjamin Franklin High School will start first and 10 at its own 25-yard line.
Ben Franklin needs to, square it up here a little bit, get a little tighter with their offense. They need to move this ball down the field and stay in the game. There's Caldwell's number 9 for 18. Not what is typical of the 66% completion average. He's had two drops that we know of today, but really good defense here by the St. Joe's Prep defenders, especially the defensive backs.
Well, let's see what he can come up with here and keep his team in this football game. Pass almost picked by Jake Strain, and that would have been 6 The quick pass to the right side, but Strain got in front of it, batted it down, and almost grabbed the football.
Hey, you see Strain here. He's starting to read the plays. This has happened once too often. He saw him knock down a pass before. That time he almost got both hands on it and took it in for an easy score.
Jake Strain, 6'3", 235-pound senior. One of the leaders on defense, a National Honor Society member. Good football player. So now the last four passes thrown by Kevin Caldwell have been three incompletes and one interception.
And almost two.
Second and 10. Pass down the right side, has a man. Rasheem James dropped it. Rasheem James was open. The ball was slightly underthrown, but James was unable to grab it.
Again, you see Caldwell throwing this ball on the run, off his back foot again. But James should have had this football. A little underthrown, but he should have had the football.
And so it is third down and 10. Franklin has converted one of three third downs, prep 0 for 2. The one they did convert was a
26-yard gain.
Yeah, third and 21, right? They had the 26-yard gain. Here it's third and 10. Pressure coming. Caldwell on the move, throws, batted down by John Reed. Incomplete pass, and it is fourth down. So after starting out 9 of his first 14, Caldwell has cooled off here.
And they've typically got 8 guys back in the, on the defensive secondary, and they're starting to make their impact felt. Look at Reed reading again the eyes of Kevin Caldwell and where he was going. And Caldwell had another guy open that time, just didn't pull the trigger fast enough.
Michael Kane was the intended receiver. But with the incomplete, it's a punt situation. Swift is back deep to receive. High snap. It bounces around midfield and will roll dead at the 44. So that's where St. Joseph's Prep will begin. First and 10 at its own 44. We've got 8:04 left in the second quarter. The Hawks 20, the Electrons 6. Gabe Infante, coach of the St. Joe's Hawks.
That's Clements over there talking to his offensive line. He ought to be patting them on the back. They've done a great job today of opening holes for the running game and on that last play, protecting him on that long pass play.
So the ball spotted at the 44. Jack Clements, the quarterback. Had that one play touchdown drive in the last possession. This is
Benny Walls.
Yeah, one play for loss of yardage.
Boy, he was stoned at the line of scrimmage right here. Somebody got through this defensive line and, oh, great tackle.
Walls
comes in for one play and I think he wished he didn't.
Yeah. Loss of one on the play. And flags come flying here.
Substitution, defense, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
An illegal substitution by Ben Franklin.
Moves the ball to the 48 and make it second down at 6.
Well, that really hurt you because you had a play that was for a loss and now you're second in about 6.
They hand it off, keeping it on the ground here. Benny Walls carrying it again. Gain of 2.
Interesting to see Walls in this game right now.
Player shaken up here is Jameer Tony. Jameer Williams was the Ben Franklin player who got shaken up. He is walking off under his own power. And play resumes now with third down. Third and 4 with the ball right at the 50-yard line. Now we'll see what Jack Clements has here. James Bell is the running back off his right shoulder.
Swift and Zacchaeus are in receiver positions.
Yeah. That's Zacchaeus wide left and Swift slot right. They put it in the hands of Bell, and he's got the first down and more. Bell across the 35 and spinning up to about the 30-yard line. James Bell. 15-yard gain.
Yeah, with everybody spread out here, they didn't figure there'd be a run up the middle. They give it to Bell. Again, look at the blocking that goes on at the line of scrimmage. And he makes a nice move right there to pick up some additional yards. Not bad, or not a bad runner for your third running back.
Yes. First down, Clements throws. Was it caught? Yes. Zacchaeus with the reception and a short gain.
Great play by Zacchaeus. Underthrown ball by Clements. But Zacchaeus pulls it off the top of his shoes. Makes the play and gets in best stays in bounds.
Ball comes to about the 25. It's a 5-yard gain. So second and five at the 25. They hand it off to Walls on the delay. He's hit hard but spins forward and picks up the first down. Crossing the 20 and getting to the 18.
Benny Walls is the fourth running back in this scenario, and he's a junior. And if you'd watch again, Walls runs a little high, but the blocking up front is exceptional. They are blowing people off the ball there, leading the way, John Runyon Jr.
Benny Walls has come in and taken a couple of hits. How about the difference in rushing yardage for these two teams? Franklin minus six on the ground. And Prep 199. Snap comes to Zacchaeus.
Wildcat.
And he gets to the 15.
First time we've seen that, John.
Yeah.
Came right back to Zacchaeus. He picks up about 4 yards on the play. Now let's take a look at this offensive line again. Zacchaeus running behind a very good offensive line. You see him not as good as before, not opening a big hole, but still winning the job in the trenches has been the St. Joe's Prep offensive line.
And the Wildcat it directly back to Zacchaeus. And he works his way to about the 15 here. Very short gain this time.
And this is a must hold situation for Ben Franklin right here. Another touchdown would really put them behind the eight ball, although they have the passing attack to catch up.
David Carter's team backing up, but it is third down here.
And Clements is back on the field at quarterback.
Third and six. That is Swift off the left shoulder of Clements. And Clements will gaze to the sideline to get some instructions. Shares them with his line. Third and six. Swift through a big opening. DeAndre Swift walks into the end zone. Touchdown, St. Joe's Prep. Big opening on the exchange from Jack Clements. And then a little move, a cut back to the right. And the lane was wide open for the sophomore.
John, this
DeAndre
showed you about
Swift.
Three different skills here. Watch how he waits till the hole opens up, dashes through it, great vision, heads to the outside again. And he's moving forward as he makes these moves. That's what really is impressive. Just a sophomore.
They're going to go for two. They had missed a kick earlier, so they'll try to make up for it here. Three men in the backfield. Clements will throw, fires through the hands, incomplete, intended for Jake Strain. High pass. Strain was open, a well-conceived play, but it didn't get executed.
Yeah, Clements threw this ball too high. All he had to do was just throw it up in the air, and Strain would have had it. There was nobody around him, and he just threw it too high.
So an incomplete pass, but nonetheless a 20-point lead now for the Hawks of St. Joe's Prep. With 4:16 left in the second, the Hawks 26, the Electrons 6.
Here's the drive numbers again. 8 plays, 56 yards, and the guy that has his third touchdown, DeAndre Swift. 4 rushes, 89 yards, 22 yards a carry, and 3 touchdowns. All he does is score touchdowns, right?
Yeah, 3 touchdowns on 4 carries, pretty good percentage.
He's really got great vision, as you saw on that touchdown run. The way he slowed up at the very beginning to make sure that he had the blocking scheme intact, breaks through the hole, picks up, gets the top speed very quickly, and then makes a move moving forward that just put the defender on his rear end.
Down to 4:16 left in the second. Hawks pulling out to a 20-point lead. See what the Electrons can come back with here. Rasheem James going to give it a go. And driven down along the left sideline. Actually, it was not James that time. It was Rafael Rodriguez who brought the ball back. Rafael Rodriguez got it out to, let's see where they mark it.
They're marking around the 14-yard line, I believe.
And there's Kevin Caldwell. First quarter, 9 for 14 for 109 yards and a TD. Second quarter, not as good. 0 for 6 with a pick.
And he might have had two.
Yeah, a near interception was dropped. All right, see if Caldwell can get it back together. Throws short, through the hands, and then intercepted. This is John Reed. Touchdown, St. Joe's Prep. Ball came off the hands of senior Michael Kane into the arms of John Reed, and St. Joe's Prep is now pulling away.
Well, they're certainly not making it easy for Kevin Caldwell. This ball was right on the money. And you see, receiver falls down a little bit, tries to catch it while he's on his knees, tips it right into the arms of John Reed, and it's just an easy 6 points.
And now, with just under 4 minutes left in the second, it is 32-6. Well, we talked about strength of schedule at the beginning. And St. Joe's Prep with a 7-3 record, not as good a record as the 10-0 for Franklin, as the extra point is kicked through. But St. Joe's Prep battling through those tough, tough early season road games. And that's, their coach said, Gabe Mafadi has said, that is one of the things that has made them so strong.
John Reed heading to Penn State. Here it is right here. You talk about being in the right place at the right time. He was off the receiver that time, but the tip ball came right into his hands. But you got to give him credit for being alert. I mean, some guys, this ball will be on top of him so quickly. That ball was just like the tip drill that you practice from, during the regular week. And he just made good of it and picks up 6 points. John, I got to tell you, Ben Franklin, after Prep came down and scored on six plays and took the ball 80 yards, they came right back. And I thought we were really going to have a battle of the offenses. But so far, it looks like St. Joe's Prep has made some, adjustments defensively. And they have really, taken Kevin Caldwell right now. And that is, he's 0 for 7 now, his last seven passes. Two picks and several drop balls. We'll give him credit. But he is not having his 65% completion day that he usually does.
And in going through the first part of the season, the bulk of the season, 10-0, I'm not sure Franklin has played a defense as good as the one St. Joe's Prep has throughout that time.
And, this is the first time this team has been challenged. They're down now 33-6. We're going to see what they're made of here and whether or not they can come back and challenge the St. Joe's Prep's team and make it a game of some sort. This is where you worry about the morale of your team, John.
Yeah, yep. Interesting that their coach, David Carter, and we mentioned this at the beginning, they succeed because, talking about his team, they succeed because they play with a chip on their shoulder. Well, nobody expecting them to do well. And certainly the expectations have gone down now as they've fallen way behind. Maybe they do rally. Maybe they can get together and step up.
There's Coach Carter. These are tough kids. They come from a tough neighborhood. And let's see if they can get that chip on their shoulder going, because they're going to need it here in this second quarter and again in the second half. This is going to be a penalty.
Holding offense. Penalized half the distance to the goal. Replay, first down.
Now they'll be going from around the 8-yard line, and it'll be first and 20.
The senior quarterback, Kevin Caldwell, back into the end zone. Now scrambling, yo-yoing back and forth. Good spin move. Breaks a tackle. He's doing a lot of work here. And pays the price and gets a penalty flag to boot coming out.
They're going to call that a helmet-to-helmet hit, I believe.
A couple of players shaking up a little bit.
I mean, there you go. Kevin Caldwell just... get the call here first, but Caldwell just, you know, showing some moxie there, you know, the courage that we know these guys have, trying to make something happen. And on this run, he's trying to get every yard he can, and he takes punishment as a result of it. Personal foul. Looks like we got a helmet-to-helmet hit here. You see Caldwell scrambling, I mean, really trying to get out of trouble here. And then he's coming down, and John Reed, helmet-to-helmet. That wasn't John Reed. That was 52. I had my numbers mixed up.
Brendan Noga. Came in late with the hit.
So that'd be a dead ball foul.
Ball comes out to the 22-yard line. And at that point, it'll be a first and 10.
Second and nine.
Yep.
Because of the dead ball foul.
Yep. All right, second and nine at the 22. Caldwell throwing again. Stands up in the pocket. Fires deep into coverage and a completed pass. Good catch that time and a first down in St. Joe's Prep territory at the 35, 34-yard line. Javier Buffalo with Zacchaeus covering.
Well, this is a heck of a play by Buffalo. You see Caldwell throwing up there again, and he was well covered. And you're just hoping that your man comes down with the ball, and Buffalo did. And let me tell you something. I'm watching Jake Strain on this 3- and 4-man rush. Mm. This guy is just takes no prisoners on every rushing the passer down he has.
First and 10 at the 35. That's Strain chasing again. Spins Caldwell away, and then Caldwell's dragged down by the rest of the defense. Joe Dumond finishing it off, the 6'1 junior. But it was Strain.
It was
got
Strain
it going.
To put the pressure on.
Yep.
He is just coming very, very hard and beating his man almost every time. You catch it on the replay here. You can't really see Strain coming off his left side, but he comes in there after he beats his man, gets a hand on Caldwell, and then DeMond brings him down for the sack.
Third sack by the St. Joe's Prep defense this afternoon. A loss of about 11. Caldwell seems to be shaking. Welcome back. It's third down and 22.
Yeah, well, welcome back. While you were away.
Ball at the 46-yard line. Third and 20, let's call it. At the prep 46. So Caldwell back in. Strain chasing him. Strain hitting him. Strain with the sack. Jake Strain, 6'3", senior, leading the defensive charge, and it is the fourth sack by the prep defense.
I mean, you know, you talk about playing these tough teams in the beginning of the year, and this is what happened. These guys just learn how to keep coming after you. Consistent persistence. Strain is the captain of that defense, and he's showing why on plays like that.
And so it is fourth down. And we have a timeout taken here. Looks like by St. Joe's Prep with 1:40 left. Gabe Infante wanting a little bit more extra time to try to get some offense going here in the final 1:40.
Let's take a look at some of St. Joe's Prep's alumni from this school. Richie Gannon.
You know
that I was Richie Gannon's first agent?
I did not know
that. That didn't last long. Phil Martelli, the basketball coach at St. Joe's. Great guy. Great speaker, by the way. Matty Gukas. And some outstanding. Jim McKay, one of the best.
Mm. And there are many, many more. A long and illustrious history for the school coached by Gabe Infante. His fifth year, he's a North Jersey guy. A star quarterback
as a high school player who played college football at Holy Cross and is now in his fifth year as the St. Joe's Prep coach. Punting situation for Franklin. A very short punt shanked way to the left, and a little benefit from the punt.
I don't know if we have a replay of that, but John Runyon took on the three upbacks behind the, in front of the punter by himself that time.
And nearly wreaked, actually did wreak some havoc.
Take a look at this. Watch the three guys. Here comes Runyon. I'd cringe, too. Looked like Big John tried to get over top of him. Looked like he hurtled him.
Hawks will be taking over first and 10 at their own 46. There's John Daniel Runyon playing a little defense, but more of an offensive tackle, as was his dad, and like his father, heading to the University of Michigan to continue his football career in the fall. Jack Clements, the quarterback for St. Joe's Prep. Hawks leading big, 33-6, late first half. Zacchaeus trying to find an opening and squeezes ahead, gets good yardage.
Good blocking again up front. Zacchaeus comes through the line, nice hole there, and then takes it to the outside.
8-yard gain. And it is second down and two at the 46. Flags come flying.
And I was just going to say, with 1:10 to go.
Four to play. Illegal substitution. Defense. 5-yard penalty results in a first down.
That's the second time they've had that called.
Yeah. And so the ball advances to the 41-yard line.
And that play looked like it was going to be a pass play, and with 1:07 to go, they're going to have to throw the ball a little bit here to move it if they want to get into the end zone before half.
They're coming up on the one-minute mark. Clements fakes left, throws over the middle. He's got Montague, completed pass, first down.
Montague, he was wide open on that play. I don't know who was supposed to have him. Really nice fake here by Clements. And look at Montague. If he had let him a little bit, well, maybe the free safety would have got over there. But my goodness, he was wide open on that play.
So another timeout taken here. It's with 52 seconds left. St. Joe's Prep with its second timeout. Prep leading 33-6. Ben Franklin's got some illustrious alumni.
Let's take a look at him, John.
Especially in the basketball world. Freddie Mad Dog Carter, I think, was a Ben Franklin alumnus. And Pooh Richardson. John Chaney. And if you remember Randy Woods, a great player at LaSalle in the early 90s.
Absolutely. Pooh Richardson, 12 NBA seasons. Ooh.
And UCLA for college. So the ball sitting at the 17-yard line. First and 10 for St. Joe's. This is the Catholic League champion at the Quad A level against the Public League champion at the Quad A level. The city championship game for Quad A. Winner moves on in the state playoffs and takes on Parkland from up in the Lehigh Valley in the state quarterfinals next weekend.
They got to go for two.
All right, this pass completed to John Reed coming around, crossing the five and getting right down to
the
goal line.
1 yard line, I think.
Oh, 1 yard line. And a timeout taken. This is the last
timeout.
We got
a couple guys hurt on that play. Dirks in the backfield. He's an offensive lineman with Joe DeMon. Two big guys. Now they switch out.
And they'll hand it off, and Olamide Zacchaeus takes it up the middle into the end zone for a touchdown. So behind the big offensive line and the blocking out in front, Zacchaeus.
Again,
senior running back gets into the end
zone. John, great job of blocking up here. You see that line pushing people back. And he had an easy walk into the end zone.
Nick Bill on to try the extra point, and if he makes it, the Prep will get to the 40-point mark. And the kick is through there. So with 31 seconds left in the second quarter, it is St. Joe's Prep 40 and Ben Franklin 6.
You know, we keep talking about the St. Joe's offense, but This guy, Jake Strain, I've been keeping my eye on him the whole first half, and he is really making an impression out there, and he's getting stronger as the game goes on. Here's a tip play on a crucial third down. Here's a play. He almost intercepts the ball. Again, beating his man, making the sack. He has been constant pressure today. 6'3", 235 pounds, and he's got some real quickness and speed.
Take a look at what St. Joseph's Prep has been able to accomplish to get to this game. And as this game, you know, officially is a state playoff, it's a city championship, winner of the Catholic League versus winner of the public league. But in getting through what amounts to the Catholic League playoffs, impressively, St. Joe's Prep blowing out Father Judge, crushing a very good LaSalle team, and way out in front of this previously undefeated Benjamin Franklin squad.
I personally did not see them scoring 40 points in this first half, the way the first two drives took place, but they have certainly taken command of this football game, not only offensively, but defensively.
So the Hawks will kick it off here as we get through the final seconds of the second quarter. Nick Bill drives it downfield off the hands briefly of Rasheem James. And now James in a lot of trouble and going backwards.
I'll tell you, the Ben Franklin guys have really had the dropsies with the football today, whether pass receiving or, you know, catching the kickoff. And there's another example of it right there.
Maybe the weather has something to do with it. Maybe the magnitude of the game. Maybe just the St. Joe's Prep defense.
Well, you know, they haven't been behind like this. It could be, you know, lack of focus, too.
Kevin Caldwell is back on. He had been shaken up, missed a play or two on the previous series. But Caldwell, the 5'9", 190-pound senior, is back at the controls. Got off to a good start. Caldwell had a good first quarter, but has struggled mightily here in the second period. It's Caldwell again, whipping it to the right side. Completed pass. First down, Javier Buffalo out across the 25 to the 28.
That ball had a little zip on it right there to Buffalo. And right now, they just want to get this offense moving again. Nice pass pattern by Buffalo. You see him do a nice, quick, crisp down and out. Another good throw by Caldwell. He needs to get back in stride right there, and that's a completion that he needed just to get his confidence back.
Last few seconds ticking away before halftime, though. Caldwell in trouble here. Bounces away from the rush, but now is sacked.
And again, the guy causing the problem, number 10, Jake Strain, just putting pressure on. He didn't make the tackle, but he certainly caught us the way they were playing their defensive backs off the ball, off the receivers, that they were going to give up, the 7-8 yard pass and make them throw a lot of passes in order to move the ball. And, you know, Ben Franklin took advantage of that. They threw a lot of down and outs, a couple of screen passes to the wide receivers. But as the second quarter wore on, and as the first quarter wore on, and going into the second quarter, they tightened that up and came up on the ball carriers. In addition to that, they were really putting a lot of pressure on Kevin Caldwell.
And one thing to keep in mind, if Franklin cannot turn things around and tighten this game up, there is a mercy rule in Pennsylvania high school football where in the second half, if you have a lead of more than 35 points, and St. Joe's has a 34-point lead right now, we go to a running clock. And things like ball out of bounds and incomplete passes do not stop the clock.
A timeout will stop the clock. An injury will stop the clock. Those sort of things. We'll keep you apprised of that as it goes on. But it is a mercy rule. We found out from an official up here that it is in effect for today's playoff game.
On the other hand, the coach David Carter, Benjamin Franklin, pointed out that they do not give out trophies at halftime. And so I imagine that's the message he is sending to his players, that although it seems near impossible for them to come back, let's go out and see what they could do, play with pride, and show the kind of talent and ability they showed in going through all the other games in this season for them with 10 wins and no losses.
And, John, they're going to get an opportunity to do that right away because they're going to be receiving the kickoff here. And this is something they haven't done well in the first half, is just take care of the ball on these kickoffs. So let's see if they can get a good kickoff return and get this a high-powered passing offense in motion once again.
Yeah, indeed, it'll be St. Joe's Prep kicking off. St. Joe's Prep with a 7-3 record. We said a couple of times they were 1-3 at one point very early in the season, but they played a very difficult schedule that involved
games against Don Bosco Prep in North Jersey and other nationally ranked powerhouse programs, a schedule that they feel strengthened them through the course of the season. Franklin, on the other hand, a better record, 10 wins and no losses, but exclusively against local teams and not the level of competition that the Prep played. All right, so here is Rasheem James bringing the kickoff back, getting it out to nearly the 30-yard line, and the Electrons offense will come out on the field, led by their senior quarterback number 12, Kevin Caldwell.
And you can see he's got that left hand pretty taped up. Mm. He took a fall on the brunt of the weight of him and the defender, Joe DeMonde. They came down on that one wrist, but that's not his throwing hand. So I got a feeling this kid will never give up. He's going to be able to hang in there and try to make a game of this second half. Let's see what happens.
First and 10 at the 27-yard line, and they'll keep it on the ground here to start the second half. And a couple of yards picked up there. Top running back, Jaimeer Toney.
Take a look at Kevin Caldwell's number. Here's a guy that traditionally is at 65%. He's at 12 for 23, just a little over 50%, but he's had some drops, and he's had two interceptions.
And we've got a player shaken up again. Franklin's had a couple of players shaken up through the course of the game. One of the linemen seems to be okay, Steve Ashley Barkley, 5'10", 230-pound senior.
And Barkley's going to come off the field for a play at least.
Well, we've got another one coming up later today that promises to be a tight matchup, at least by all indications. The AAA City Championship game, Archbishop Wood against Imhotep Charter. Those are teams that have both played challenging national-oriented schedules and have both amassed records of 10-1.
You're going to see a lot of great athletes on both those teams. They've got about 10 guys combined that are going to Division I schools next year.
That is the marquee game on the card this afternoon, and it comes your way beginning at about 3:30. All right, this ball comes loose. Caldwell falls on it and takes a big loss on the play, unable to grab the snap, fell on it to make sure he didn't lose it, and took the big loss.
Okay, he's been getting low snaps all day, and this one just goes right through his hands. He wasn't paying attention. That mistake is on Kevin Caldwell. He just simply missed the ball.
It comes back to the 19. It sets up third down and about 18 for a first down. Early stages of the third quarter.
And here comes St. Joe's. They've got the line of scrimmage all lined up here for a blitz.
Caldwell out of the shotgun. They back off the blitz. Caldwell's got time at first. Now in trouble, spins away, tries to motor out of trouble and cannot. Brought down behind the line of scrimmage, just behind the line of scrimmage, and it'll be fourth down.
And you're right, St. Joe's pulled out of that blitz at the last second. It's number 52 that made the sack, Brendan Noga. And that four-man rush has been so effective, I'm not sure St. Joe's needs the blitz. Mm. Again, they just pushed Kevin Caldwell out of the pocket and were able to tackle him for another loss. And they didn't take advantage of the opportunity to get the scoring going again offensively.
The dangerous sophomore DeAndre Swift is back deep to receive. The punter is Rafael Rodriguez. Rodriguez gets a short kickaway here. Takes a little bit of a roll. And now a nice roll for Franklin. It'll come right onto the 50-yard line. And so St. Joe's Prep will start first and 10 at the 50-yard line. Let's take a look at some of the work that the St. Joe's Prep defense has done this afternoon.
Led in part by Jake Strine. You see right there, that's number 4, Vandeveer, who's had a great first half. And there's Strine right there knocking the ball down. Great play here. Became the receiver, number 17, Montague. And then Johnny Reed with an interception on a tip ball. Right here, Strain again, causing problems. The defense has played really well.
Now on the offensive side, it is James Bell getting a couple of yards for the Hawks.
James Bell's got a couple of carries in the first half. The senior at 5'8", 172. Is the third running back on this team.
Tough yards here. Bell, no gain this time, and very quickly it'll be third down. Third down and about 3 at the 43-yard line.
And Zacchaeus and Swift are not even in the game at this point. Nice to be able to give your guys a break like that, but you wonder coming off of halftime if they weren't fresh enough.
Jack Clements is the quarterback, 6'4", 210 pounds, senior. Thrown for more than 1,500 yards and 19 touchdowns coming into this game. Hands it off here to Bell. He's got to get to the 40 for the first down. It's going to be a little shy, I think.
It'll be close. And I'm kind of wondering, John, with this kind of lead, maybe Coach Infante has thought that Swift and Zacchaeus, not to risk them the injury. Here you go right here, a slant pattern off the edge. You see Bell trying to get the first down. Good balance he kept there. The whistle must have blown. First down. There's Zacchaeus and Swift on the sideline.
They did have enough for the first down. The way they spotted the ball right at the 40-yard line was sufficient for the first down. And again, James Bell, the ball carrier.
Denny Walls, we've seen in action too for St. Joe's Prep. He's the fourth running back, and I'm sure that if Zacchaeus and Swift, and we don't know this, but they may be just saving them now for the next game.
And Bell, for one, is a guy who plays a lot, has rushed for more than 300 yards, and is getting some playing time here, as he often does.
And he's got that same offensive line blocking for him that the two running backs had, Swift and Zacchaeus. So don't be surprised if you see him break one here.
No gain in that play, so second down and 10. Hand off to Bell again, and this time he's wrapped up after a gain of about two or three and stopped. And so now third down very quickly.
Lafisi Ewald did a nice job of stopping him because he was well on his way to a bigger gain than that. He had him by the back of the jersey and was able to pull him down. That's going to bring up about a third and seven.
Yeah.
Neither team, John, goes to a huddle on offense. You see the St. Joe's Prep guys looking to the sideline, much like the Philadelphia Eagles.
You're really seeing that more and more at the high school level. It's a sort of a semi-huddle there, a gathering. Third and seven, passes incomplete.
Clements does a great job of managing this team, but he is not the most accurate passer. That ball was thrown way behind the receiver, and he was wide open in the flat.
Lou Sirachi, the intended receiver. And so it is fourth down and long, and St. Joe's Prep has been forced to punt, and Robert Caprice, number nine, comes out to kick. Rasheem James goes back to receive.
And I'll tell you, it looks like Ben Franklin has got the punt block on. Let's see here. They're lined up as if they do. Only got one guy back.
Oh, they do come with a rush, and Clea got very close to it in a flat.
I don't know how he missed it, John. I have no idea how Clea missed it. He was there in time.
And then he mowed into the punter, so the flag came out for presumably roughing.
And that could bring him into a first down. You take a look here. I mean, you see the call here.
Running into the kicker, defense. That penalty is declined. First down, Franklin.
Wow.
Well, because it wouldn't have been enough for the first down.
I got you. But you see right here, I don't know how Clea missed it. He just went to the wrong side. He didn't cover the ball. The ball just went outside of his left hand. He was there.
It's the difference right between roughing the kicker and running into the kicker. This is just the
5-yard penalty.
The momentum version. So 5-yard penalty, not enough for the first down, and they'll take the field position. All right, so first and 10 for Ben Franklin, and as has been the case throughout the afternoon, they start in bad field position. They're back at their own 4. And for the most part, it's been the opposite for St. Joe's Prep, which has been consistently starting around midfield. This pass is overthrown.
It was just thrown away. He had nobody open. He did the right thing, Kevin Caldwell, by throwing the ball out of bounds. St. Joe's really tightening up their defense now, coming up to the line of scrimmage to cover the wide receivers, almost at the line at times. In the first quarter, they were way off the ball.
So second down and 10 at the 4-yard line. Caldwell standing in the end zone to receive this snap. And throwing incomplete.
Javier Buffalo, the intended receiver.
Buffalo has made some catches. That ball was thrown a little bit behind him, John, but I thought he had an opportunity to catch it. Kevin Caldwell's got to be frustrated right now. This guy hasn't had a game like this all season. And he's really struggling right now just to get first downs going. Another third and 10.
Mm. And what a season Kevin Caldwell has had, throwing for more than 2,500 yards, a city record 35 touchdowns, and only two interceptions all year, and he's had that this afternoon. Throwing down the right side, tipped and incomplete, almost picked off.
And you know, that's kind of a desperate pass right there. That is not a pass you would want to be anybody have thrown in a game that was close. But right now, they're grasping at straws to get something going. And Caldwell had the only opportunity he had to was to throw the ball up in the air and hope that his guy came down with it. And that did not happen.
So a three and out. And punt formation now coming up for Ben Franklin. Rafael Rodriguez punting. DeAndre Swift on the return. High, and again, a very short punt.
Very short.
And this one will take a sideways bounce and
come dead at the 16-yard line.
16, so only a 12-yard punt, and things are not going right for Ben Franklin on really all facets of the game at this point. Let's see what they can do here. They had a good defensive stop. On the first possession for St. Joe's Prep, but this time the Hawks will start at the 16-yard line. And here comes St. Joe's Prep. There's the Ben Franklin defense.
And it's James Bell comes out again. No QB this time. Direct snap from center. New QB. Yeah. 19. I thought that was a 15. I thought it was a wildcat, but it's a new quarterback.
And it's Kevin Shaw, 5'11", 155-pound junior.
False start. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
And that's what happens when you get a new signal caller in there. A mistake right off the bat.
So Gabe Infante, the St. Joe's coach, going to mostly reserves here with his team way out in front. James Bell carrying, losing the football. It is picked up by Franklin and a turnover. St. Joe's Prep's James Bell losing it and the ball recovered by, looks like, Rafael Rodriguez.
Bell makes a nice gain here off the left side, but as he's struggling to get additional yardage when he gets hit, he's stripped of the football. If you can see right here, nice blocking there, but the ball gets stripped. And Ben Franklin recovers, an opportunity for him.
I think Taj Clea was the defender who got his hand on the ball carrier, yep.
Now they still have the opportunity of running behind the first string line. Runyon still in there along with Mooney and the rest of the crew. So Bell has, you know, he wants to get in there. He wants to get into the ball game and score and be a part of this winning tradition here. Get some points on the board, but he's stripped there.
Another. Franklin has its first and so you see Poulsen stretching out, seems to be okay, and Franklin has its first and 10 now. Here's a completed pass in the left flat. And this is what they were doing right at the beginning of the first quarter, very successfully, chipping away, moving the sticks, going downfield.
And then they had some drop passes, and they weren't able to convert on third downs, but you see Kevin Caldwell with that quick wrist pass that he has, and he throws a really quick ball out there to his wide receiver.
It's been a while since he'd completed a pass. He had a very good first quarter and then struggled in the second period. This is short of a first, about a 9-yard gain, so second and one. Clements airing it out down on the right side.
Wow,
Rodriguez bringing it in. That's a first down and more out beyond the 40-yard line.
Rodriguez initially, I think, we're going to watch, but I think he caught this ball with one hand and brought it down. But a really nice catch by Rodriguez. Ball on target for only him to get. He was pretty well covered here, but you watch. Ball thrown high enough. Rodriguez gets up. One hand brings it down. Watch this. It is all one-handed. And then he puts it and tucks it away with the other hand.
First down at the 42-yard line. Caldwell guns it complete. short of the first down. Quick tackle made by Nick Vandeveer. Catch made by Rasheem James.
Vandeveer's had a really nice game so far. Sure tackle that time. Keeping the man, catching the ball in front of you, you'll give up those short passes.
6 yard gain, no huddle. Franklin comes up to the line of scrimmage. Second down at short yardage at about their own 48 yard line. Middle stages of the third quarter.
A little confusion here on offense for Ben Franklin. Now they get everybody set.
St. Joe's prep way out in front, 40-6, but Benjamin Franklin looking to put something together here. Caldwell. Pump fake. Dancing. Sacked. Another sack by the St. Joe's line. This is more of a coverage sack. He had the time initially, couldn't find anybody open, and then got buried under.
And they've definitely got, St. Joe's has got some of their second team guys in on defense, and that was some of the second tier players making the sack on Kevin Caldwell there.
They lose about 4 yards back to their own 44-yard line, so make it third down and 8. As you see the Franklin sideline, there's the quarterback, Kevin Caldwell. And the snap. Caldwell under pressure. Throwing, nearly intercepted. Ball knocked away, incomplete.
And Frank Franklin's going to get called for a hold.
Yeah. Come console with the defensive play.
Armin Ware, number 34, was really putting pressure on Kevin Caldwell, and the guy held him to keep him from making another sack.
Might decline this, right, because it would be fourth down. But right. Let's see.
Fourth down. Holding. Offense. That penalty's declined. Fourth down.
Yeah, they'll take the fourth down, St. Joe's will. Although with the score being what it is, and with the punting game being a little erratic, Benjamin Franklin will set up to go for it here on fourth down. At their own 44, so fourth and 8. For the Electrons at their own 44-yard line. Caldwell steps up in the pocket, throws downfield, has a man, it's too far. Javier Buffalo is open, had the step, but the ball was beyond his reach.
Things just not going right for Ben Franklin today.
Timeout on the field, we'll go to a break. 3:05 left in the third quarter. There's their defensive coordinator. The defense has been solid. It's the offense on the field now. The backup quarterback, a lot of backups in there for St. Joe's prep. And here's James Bell.
James Bell.
Yards.
Really nice run here, running hard. Nice hole opened up for him. And now the second team offensive line is in, and they're doing a nice job. Look at the hole he had to run through. And if it wasn't for the tackle there by Corion Carlisle, that might have gone all the way.
James Bell has amassed a little bit of yardage here. 11 carries, 67 yards, not bad.
Bad 7 yard third string back.
Yep. 7 yard run
string,
here.
But third back, I should say.
And now on second down and 4. Couple of yards.
I think Bell may have gotten it, or he's darn close to it.
James Bell, yep, did get enough for the first down there at the 34.
See number 72 in there, Brian Smith in. Junior replacing John Runyon, I believe.
Last 2 minutes of the third quarter now.
Jackson Evans, also a sophomore, number 77 in the Blairs, John Runyon. Looks like his dad.
Shaw, the backup quarterback, hands it off, and a lot of running room here for Bell. Bell down the left sideline, crosses the 15 and goes out of bounds at the 13. Another 20-plus yard run. James Bell with this one here.
There you see, just a handoff. Nowhere to go in the middle. These guys take it outside as well as any team I've seen. Their first reaction when there's something blocked is to take it outside, and they get to the outside quickly. Nice gain for Bell there.
They get a 22-yard run, spot the ball at the 12, and call it first and 10 from there. Kevin Shaw hands it off. James Bell again, dancing across the 5-yard line and close to another first down at about the 3.
And he's pretty close to 100 yards now with those two runs.
Yep.
They're going to list the ball at the 4-yard line.
Mm-hmm. So second an eight-yard run. And make it second down and 2.
Yeah, second and 2.
Kevin Shaw hands it off to Bell. He's got the first down. Does he have the touchdown? Not quite.
Boy, he's really close.
3-yard gain down to the 1-yard line.
That looked like a scrum that time, John. And they line right up again, trying to catch Ben Franklin off guard.
Quarterback sneak. Kevin Shaw trying to push his way in.
And do we have a sign yet? No signal. Touchdown.
Touchdown it is. We had the sign from the St. Joe's Hawks players, but we needed it from the refs.
Kevin Shaw getting in with a touchdown here. Mm-hmm. They line up very quickly trying to keep Ben Franklin.
Then they've got the Thanksgiving. I'm not sure when that state quarterfinal game. If it's scheduled for next weekend, that would be 3 games in 7 days. That seems above and beyond the call of duty.
Yeah, that would really be testing your people.
Yeah, I can't say exactly how that gets handled. But it's hard to imagine they would schedule that many games that close together.
You'd have one practice day. That would be after a game. That would be odd.
All right, after the touchdown, St. Joe's Prep kicking it off, sending it through the end zone for a touchback, good kickoff. And so as a result, Benjamin Franklin will start at its own 20-yard line with just 38 seconds now, 39 seconds showing on the third quarter clock.
And as soon as this ball is snapped, we will go to the running clock because the score now is more than a 35-point difference. And that's when the running clock goes into effect.
Kevin Caldwell remains in at quarterback. And to give you an idea of the kind of game it's been for Ben Franklin, they're starting out at their own 20. It's actually one of their better field positions since the early stages of the game. Get some ground yardage here.
Well, they'd catch you off guard with that. I mean, they're down by 41 points.
Jaimeer Toney, a pretty good running back, headed to Marshall University in Huntington, West Virginia next year.
St. Joe's Prep now has all second-string defense in.
9-yard gain. It's second and 1. Final play here, most likely, of the third quarter. Kevin Caldwell remaining in at quarterback. Sends it to the right sideline. Complete. Javier Buffalo roaming down the right sideline and finally dragged out of bounds.
Brendan Noga stopping him from going all the way.
And so we have now come to the end of the third quarter. And St. Joe's Prep in control. Fourth quarter coming up. The Hawks 47. The Electron 6. Fourth quarter next on the Comp.
SEPTA is the way to get to games.
I love East High School, Charles Martin Memorial Stadium, St. Joe's Prep with the big second quarter, and then tacking on 7 more points in the third. They go to the fourth, leading 47-6. A lot of hearty fans sticking it out. Crisp autumn afternoon, temperature in the low mid-40s, maybe getting to the mid-40s, windy. But clear blue skies. Kevin Caldwell looking to throw, completes a pass. This is Rafael Rodriguez dancing backwards and then surrounded by white shirts, but inside the 20-yard line.
Nice pattern run here by Rodriguez and another good throw by Caldwell. Caldwell's release is really quick. A lot of zip on that ball right there. Nice catch, nice run. Corralled by the St. Joe's defense.
The Electrons on a drive that began at their own 20-yard line. They're now inside the prep 20 at the 18. First and 10, it's Caldwell out of the shotgun. Another low snap, but he fields it. Flings it down the left sideline for the end zone. Complete. Touchdown, Buffalo.
Javier Buffalo's had a big game, hauling that one in the end zone. And for the first time since the first quarter, Benjamin Franklin is on the scoreboard.
This looks like one of those old-fashioned alley-oop passes, John. Caldwell threw it up there. Buffalo pretty well covered. Two defenders there, but he comes down with the football. And now they're going to go for two.
It is 47-12. And with a kicking game that has been erratic, they set up to try a two-point conversion. Caldwell looks, pulls the trigger, and completes the pass for the two-point conversion. Rodriguez on the reception, so they get the two-point conversion. And here in the first minute of play in the fourth quarter, Franklin gets back on the board. It is 47-14.
Here you see Caldwell zip another tight pass into his receiver, just about open. Nice catch, but really a quick pass there to Rodriguez. And here's a touchdown pass here. Nice throw, but better reception. He was able to get his feet planted and went up for the ball like a jump ball in basketball, and he comes down with it. Take a look at it from one more angle. Another low snap to Caldwell. He's been getting those all day. Just excellent position. Javier Buffalo, and he gets the score. Now, that'll take us off of the running clock. No, it won't. I'll take that back. It should. 33 points, okay.
The clock, as you see, is stopped at the moment at 11:14. And St. Joe's prep with that big lead. Franklin will be kicking it off here. And DeAndre Swift has returned to the field along with Alameda Zacchaeus. Really, for the first time in the second half, they are on the field as kick returners here. There's Zacchaeus, the senior heading for the University of Virginia.
I don't understand that. Why you would put these guys in jeopardy of running back a kickoff?
Onside kick attempt here.
They're going to do that. Don't worry about it.
Indeed, recovered by the Hawks. So even though we're just updating the exact rules here, even though the lead has been trimmed to less than 35 points, the running clock situation, once we went into that situation,
continues.
Yep.
Now, see, I do some games in Delaware where that is not in effect. You come within the 35-point range, that goes back to the regular clock. So different rules in different states, and I stand corrected.
Yet another quarterback we're looking at. There's running back Benny Walls, who saw a little bit of action. You know, it's not Benny Walls. It's a little bit further down the depth chart. Christian Walter carrying the football.
And Joe Longo is in right now at the quarterback slot. He's a junior, 5'8", 150. Getting an opportunity to get some snaps in the championship city game.
So we've seen now three quarterbacks play for St. Joe's Prep. As we move past the 10-minute mark in the fourth quarter. Ball at the 49-yard line, second down and about 7 yards. Longo again hands it off, and St. Joe's continues to move it forward with Waller carrying.
Waller, just a sophomore, as you said, 5'6", 155. Looks like he's got a few moves there, John. All these guys looking to the sideline. Check out what the play is going to be called. You're right, they've got kind of a semi-huddle now, but they're not saying anything in that huddle. They're all just huddled up looking to the sideline. And they come out very quickly.
First down at the 42, Longo hands it off to Waller, and he's tripped up at the line of scrimmage and brought down there. So, you know, St. Joe's Prep here just looking to wind out the clock. We're very quickly coming up on the 9-minute mark. They've got the big lead.
Edward Dennis making the tackle there. Nice play by number 25.
No benefit to any kind of running up the score here, so they'll just look to grind out some clock. Second down and 12. Ball spotted at the 44-yard line.
If you're one of these second-tier players, though, this is exciting, getting into a city championship game. Mm. especially if you're for St. Joe's Prep. And they're taking a lot of clock time off the clock, taking their time with calling the plays.
Longo hands it off to Waller, brought down, again, just across the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten back to the original line, so a gain of about 1 or 2 yards.
And again, Edward Dennis in on the tackle.
Spotted at the 43, so a 1 yard gain, and call it third down and 11. Crossing the 8 minute mark now, third down and 11. You see the St. Joe's Prep bench, again, taking their time on the field, winding some clock down.
And John, you know, this is a bad defeat for Ben Franklin. I know they expected much better of themselves today, but you know, you got to look back at an undefeated season coming into this game and be proud of what you accomplished and all the points you put up on the board. Today just wasn't their day, and St. Joe's Prep just really has just a little more talent on their side of the ball, and they do the offense, running and throwing, a little bit better.
On third and long, Waller stops up at the line of scrimmage, and just like that, it'll be fourth down. Yeah, this is a Ben Franklin team that was 10-0, first public league title in decades, and a team that averaged 43 points per game in racking up that 10-0 record. So indeed, a lot for them to be proud of.
There's our head coach, still yelling out encouragement to the team.
St. Joe's will go for it on fourth down here. No doubt keep it on the ground once again, I would suspect. And use up a little bit more clock.
There's another big guy in the offensive lineup. You can see him there, number 79. Carter Lynch, 6'5", 320.
They hand it off to Waller, and he's close to that first down.
Yeah.
He needed 11, and he darn near got
there. This is what I'm telling you about these guys. They, you know, they get excited about being in a game like this. This is an opportunity for them.
Yeah, it is enough for the first down.
Just enough for a first down. And Waller gets us on his own. Great blocks up front. He runs through a big hole, but then watch him carry some people and get that extra effort to get that first down.
Yep. So the Hawks, you know what, did he, I'll tell you what, I think he came up short.
He did.
It's first down for Frank. He came up a couple of inches short. Yep.
Just a couple inches short. Ben Franklin will take over. But it wasn't for lack of effort, John. I'll tell you that. He was really pushing hard.
So, yeah, first down indeed, but it's a first down on downs for Franklin. And now inside the six-minute mark of what is still a 47-14 game.
Kevin Caldwell still in at quarterback.
Fires it down the left side. This is Rodriguez. Spins and gets free across the 20-yard line. Foot race. And Rodriguez is in the end zone. Touchdown. 66-yard pass and run. A little of excitement here in the late stages. Kevin Caldwell to Rafael Rodriguez. And the electrons are back on the scoreboard.
Kevin Caldwell got protection this time. Waited until his man made the move. Throws the ball where only he can get it. Nice catch there by Rodriguez. Then he just simply outruns everybody to the end zone.
And so with 5:33 left in the fourth quarter, it is now a 27-point game with the extra point, a two-point conversion attempt upcoming. They keep it on the ground for the two-point attempt, and I think they've got it.
They do.
They do. Jaimeer Toney carrying it in for the two-point conversion. And with 5:34 left in the fourth, it is the Prep 47, Benjamin Franklin, 22.
When you set out to find new roads, you obsess over perfection. Elevate form and reinvent a category. You also attract a lot of attention. Chevrolet, the most awarded car company of the year. Not Ford, Honda, or Toyota. Get great offers all month long at the Chevy Black Friday sale on these models and more.
Get 0% financing plus $1,000 and no monthly payments until next year on this Silverado Double Cab All-Star Edition.
35 touchdowns. Rodriguez caught a city record 17 touchdowns. And now two more to get to 19 touchdowns. It looks like 34 left in the fourth quarter. It's now the Hawks 47 and the Electrons 22. There's Rafael Rodriguez, 5'10", 190-pound junior. Five catches today, 140 yards, and now two touchdowns.
That was a nice play he made on the last one. Nice catch, nice run after the catch. Showed some speed there in getting to the end zone and outrunning the defensive players for St. Joe's.
We, you know, we talked about Kevin Caldwell throwing a city record 35 touchdowns. Rodriguez caught a city record 17 touchdowns, and now two more to get to 19 touchdowns. It looks like an onside kick attempt. So
St. Joe's Prep's got their hands, people up front, receivers and running backs.
Here's the squibbler. It did not cross the 50-yard line.
That ball came backwards.
Yeah, it's got to, you know, got across the 50. And so it's downed at the 44, and St. Joe's will take over at that point.
The spin on that football was really odd. It just spun like a top and actually came backward. Take a look at this on the replay. Had an opportunity to be very hard to handle, but watch, it almost goes backwards.
Mm. All right, so first down for the Hawks at the 44. Let's see who's the quarterback this time. We've got another quarterback handing the football off. Yeah. 16, John Barbera. 6 foot sophomore has come in. There he is. So Jack Clements was the starter. We saw a little of Kevin Shaw, some of Joe Longo. And now Barbera is in at quarterback.
And that last carry for no gain again was number 32, Christian Waller.
Mm.
Yeah, he's probably been stuck behind these running backs with their three seniors there. So next year he'll probably get some running time here, John.
And John Barbera, a sophomore at quarterback, perhaps another part of the future for St. Joe's Prep. Tough hit and no gain for Waller on this play.
And see some of these second-tier guys for Ben Franklin like being in the game. There's some hard hitting going down there. There's Waller right there, junior.
Timeout taken by Benjamin Franklin, so the clock stopped with 4:36 left. The Franklin team does not have the depth that they just don't have as many players on their roster that St. Joe's Prep has, and so they don't have the same opportunity to go to reserve players that St. Joe's Prep does. Hey, before Chip Kelly leads the Eagles against the Tennessee Titans tomorrow, break down the Birds' game plan on Eagles. Could be. Boy, that would be a disaster. All right, here's Waller getting a couple of yards straight up the gut on a third down play. And let's see if Franklin's going to stop the clock again here. This is the second of their three timeouts. So the coach, David Carter, using this as a learning opportunity, a teaching moment. Hey, in just an hour and 15 minutes, more high school football, and it is the main event coming up for today, or at least what we are anticipating to be a tremendous matchup. It is the city championship game at the AAA level, and it involves Catholic League AAA champion Archbishop Wood against Public League AAA champion Imhotep. Both of these teams have played rugged schedules, both have multiple Division I players, both have 10 wins and 1 losses. The cheerleaders from Archbishop Wood already arriving, getting an early start, getting ready to go. This game coming up at 3:30 figures to be a tremendous football game. A lot of anticipation. All right, fourth down, and again with the score being what it is, St. Joe's Prep will run a play here. They'll run a pass play. And it is going to be an incomplete pass thrown by Kevin Shaw, who had returned at quarterback. Darryl Simmons, a freshman, number 87, was the intended receiver. And so St. Joe's Prep again turns it over on downs. And Benjamin Franklin takes over at their own 42-yard line. Clock continues to run. And we are inside of 4 minutes now.
And Kevin Caldwell is still the quarterback for Ben Franklin. And they're not going to go away easily today.
And they've scored a couple of touchdowns against the reserves for St. Joe's Prep, and they're looking for more. Pass gunned over the middle into traffic, incomplete, intended for Buffalo.
And I think Buffalo felt the traffic coming. There were three guys conversion on him. He took his eyes off that football because it hit him in the hands. And we've seen him make a catch like that.
That is a case of a Buffalo facing a stampede.
Yes, I think you're right. Take a look at this replay here. Thrown in the traffic, but, you know, late in the game with nothing to lose, this is what's going to happen. But he's got three guys around him and a fourth coming quickly. Pass was right there.
Second down and 10 at the 42-yard line. And now just over 3 minutes remaining. And clock is running despite the incomplete pass because of the mercy rule that went into effect when the St. Joe's Prep lead exceeded 35 points. Here's a pass gunned over the middle, complete inside the 30-yard line.
Rodriguez had it, but he dropped it.
He never
got control of it.
It was Michael Kane.
I'm sorry, Michael Kane. Michael Kane went up nicely. Looked like he had control of the ball, but when he came down, it came loose.
Yep.
Another nice pass there by Kevin Caldwell. Right there, he goes up. Looks like he has it for a second, but never really was able to bring it in.
And so it is third down and 10. And let's see what Caldwell can do here.
Tomorrow morning when you look at the paper and you see Caldwell's numbers, you're going to say he must have had a good day. Well, not really, but he did put up some yardage.
Good start, good finish. Struggled in the middle of the game, second and third quarters. Looking downfield here, guns it. It's got a man open, and again, the pass is dropped. Catchable ball, very, very much so, but Rasheem James, the guilty party on this one.
Well, that one was right on the money, and Rasheem James knows he should have had that pass. Right on the money. James breaks loose. Take one more look at this. It might have come off his pads. See, when you should catch the ball with your hands. You let it get in touch with those pads, and it can bounce around on you. And he knows he had a touchdown there if he catches the football.
And so it is fourth down. And now just a minute 27 left in the fourth quarter. Caldwell lined up in the shotgun formation.
They're changing the play. He got it from the sideline. He just let his wide receivers know.
Yeah. Has time. Completes it in the right flat. And now does have the first down. Rasheem James, who dropped the pass earlier, catching this one. And with the run following the catch, got enough for the first down. But now just 50 seconds and counting in the fourth quarter. Quick count this time. Caldwell. Guns it complete. Buffalo's got it. Circling back to the left, down at the 30-yard line.
Close to a first down, but not quite.
And now Franklin is going to use its final timeout. At the 26-second mark.
26 seconds to go. Another nice pass, nice catch here. Just a little bit of too little, too late. Look at that ball that he throws. Kevin Caldwell throws a nice tight spiral. Nice catch by Buffalo. He's got a quick release too. Look at that ball. The ball is perfectly spiraled. He's going to have well over 300 yards passing today.
He's got 332 yards passing.
19 for 36. Over 50%. Yep. He's had about four balls dropped, I would say.
Yeah.
Maybe five.
Had an interception drop, too.
Yeah, he did.
So the coach, David Carter, wants his team to have one more crack at getting six here, even though it won't matter in the result, but give the kids the opportunity to try to score it here with 26 seconds remaining.
St. Joe's going to go back in a prevent defense. Their safeties are back inside the 10-yard line, anticipating it's going to be a bomb.
Caldwell. Now under pressure. Flags are down. And incomplete. thrown short, intended for Rafael Rodriguez.
And there's a penalty. It's going to be a holding penalty, I think.
They'll stop the clock here for a moment while they sort it out.
Let's see what the call is.
Holding, offense, number 77, 10-yard penalty. Replay first down. Come on, hurry, we're going to wind it.
So the ball comes back out to the 45-yard line. And now the clock will resume ticking inside the 22nd mark. Might be the final play.
Yeah, it could be the final play of the game.
Caldwell throwing it downfield. And it is incomplete off the hands of Rasheem James. And the clock does wind down to zero. And the final score is in the books. And so Gabe Infante and the St. Joe's Prep Hawks have advanced. They've won the Quad A City Philadelphia Championship. And they move on to the state quarterfinals, where they will play Parkland out of the Lehigh Valley next weekend. Big win for St. Joe's Prep. Close game in the early stages of the first quarter. They broke it open with a big second quarter and cruised in the second half, winning it by the score of 47-22.
Zacchaeus and Swift just proved to be too much for this Ben Franklin defense today. Those two guys really put on a show, especially DeAndre Swift.
And we'll talk about their defense, too. But before we do that, let's take a break and then come back with continuing coverage of the city championship games on the Comcast Network. Today, and it begins with the Quad A Philadelphia City Championship game. Live from Northeast High School off of Cottman Avenue in Philadelphia, it's the Public League champion Electrons of Benjamin Franklin against the Catholic League champion Hawks of St. Joseph's Prep. A very pleasant good morning to you watching. This is John Gurevich along with Kevin Riley. Big day of high school football coming up.
Crisp, clear weather, not a cloud in the sky. Probably a dozen or more kids that you're going to see play at the next level. I'm sure a lot of college coaches are watching this game.
St. Joe's Prep, a team that comes in at 7-3. They were 1-3 early in the season, but Kevin, they played a brutal early season schedule.
And that was done on purpose. Coach Infante, one of these guys that cut their, you know, football skills at a higher level so that they brought out the best in the prep. And we'll see here today if that game ball played off.
A lot of talent on the St. Joe's Prep team, and it begins with a sophomore, DeAndre Swift.
This guy has the total package. Only a sophomore, 5'9", 200 pounds. He catches, he runs, he's fast. He's all better than offered a Division I scholarship.
He's not the only star runner on this team, though. Senior Olamide Zacchaeus, a guy who's ticketed to the University of Virginia to continue his football career, is a big factor as well.
Well, he adds the 1-2 punch to this team that might be unstoppable today. This guy's 5'9", 192 pounds, a little more power. You see right here, he's got the speed to take it all the way when he breaks into the open. These two guys are going to be a problem for the prep today.
All right, now for Benjamin Franklin High School, they don't play quite the schedule that St. Joseph's Prep plays, but Franklin got through its schedule undefeated at 10-0, and they've been beating up on their opponents.
Well, take a look at the scores. They've really been beating up on people, and that's because they have a prolific passing attack. This passing attack looks like something out of the Green Bay Packers, and we're going to talk about who leads that passing attack. It's no other than Kevin Caldwell, 5'9", 192 pounds. He throws the ball about as well as anybody. He can throw it long, he can throw it short, and guess what? When there's nobody open, he can also run the football. This is the guy that is really setting records in the public league. 35 touchdowns this year for a new city record.
A lot of talent on both sides of the ball, a lot of Division I attendees, a lot of Division I future players. Kevin Caldwell, just one of a number of fine players we'll be seeing. A lot of talent, a second football game coming up later this afternoon. That's the AAA championship. But first, we've got the Quad A championship. St. Joe's Prep, the Hawks, the Catholic League champion against Ben Franklin. Next.